Spain's travel industry constantly gets buffeted by other countries and the decisions taken in faraway capitals. For instance, the United Kingdom, which took another decision which is going to wallop Spain. Ibiza, Mallorca, Menorca have now been moved to the UK's amber list, which means unvaccinated travellers must quarantine when they return back home to those to England. The result of which has pushed ticket prices up quite considerably. But don't forget, in some cases, vaccinated from those places don't have to. It's very confusing over what's actually going on. Iberia is the national airline of Spain. It's part of IAG, which is also British Airways, Aer Lingus, and so forth. The Iberia chief executive told me he's seeing signs of the green shoots of recovery. We spoke in the lounge at Madrid's Barajas Airport. And as the chief executive and I got talking, well, behind us, a plane started to move. He was delighted. A welcome sign for you.
Okay, new flight.
A flight that is leaving.
It's leaving, yeah.
Hopefully with passengers, lots of passengers.
Hopefully with passengers. You know, the experience that is really frustrating is when you, I usually fly in the flight deck. So when you are landing at London and you see that the body is moving, nothing is moving at London, only your plane. Similar thing here in Madrid, although in Madrid, there are more movements because the restrictions are less intensive than in London. But yeah, it's been a tough time this month, and we are seeing signs of recovery, green shoots, in a way.
So you say green shoots. Surely we're seeing more than green shoots now. I mean, this sapling is growing.
Well, it depends. How do you look at this? Is it half empty glass or half full glass? It's 60% of our operations, double than in 3 months, but still, is 40% less than in 2019. Imagine in 2019 someone come and tell you, okay, you know what? Your demand will be reduced by 40%. You will be, wow. So, but yes, I mean, we've seen this trend of improvement.
So when we look at your long haul operations, particularly of course Latin America, the main effects there are what?
The situation is more related to the vaccination process and how that process is evolving. So unfortunately, in some of the countries of Latin America, we're lagging behind, and you know that's our main market. In some other, we see some stability. And I think it's also really related to the opening of the borders and the restrictions. So what we see is that there is pent-up demand. And when a country is open, we see that demand flowing.
Right, so the decision by Spain to open up must have been very welcome.
Very welcome. Yeah. No, very welcome. I think that the government of Spain has proven flexible, and I think that we all understand that the tourism is of the essence of this country. It's the first contributor to the GDP, the second contributor also to the employment. So I think that the Spanish government has been very proactive in opening.
So where do you see, as the CEO of Iberia, where do you see it within IAG? The growth and contribution it's going to make.
I think that we have a common aim, that is to develop this hub and to compete in a more efficient way with the northern hubs, and to develop develop Madrid and to develop Spain. And that needs to be also good for the customers, because this is a hub that is also only looking to the west. We need to look also to the east. And that's one of the pillars also of this acquisition.
The investment that you're going to make, where will it be?
We will continue investing in the customer, not only just in the plane, also in the customer journey, all the touch points. We want this to be more efficient, be more digital. And we're investing money on that. We're trying to manage this crisis with, I used to say that we are managing this with a microscope and a telescope. With the microscope, we need to keep liquidity, we need to do a lot of stuff, reduce the fixed costs and all that, but also with the telescope. And Air Europa, the development of the hub, the investment in the customer is part of the telescope side.
We're here at the moment, but you as the CEO have to think about where the airline's going to be, not just next month, but in 5 years' time.
Yep.
that's pretty impossible at the moment.
Well, it's we're trying to anticipate that. One of the things that we have learned over the crisis, this crisis, is that we need to be more flexible and more agile. So those mechanisms are things that will stay in the airline. The other thing is, I think that we, in terms of how our customers will behave, we are seeing some trends that I think will stay.
Like, really?
For instance, well, some trends, like, for instance, they want a more agile also customer journey. They want something that is a bit, let's say, touchless. They want more digital. So I'm not saying that the situation that we are having now with the e-commerce is sustainable, but I do think that part of this will stay.
Well, your lounge is up and running.
Up and running. I'm happy. I'm happy that it's up and running. The only thing I would like to see is more customers enjoying the lounge. But we see the ramp up. I mean, this has been open 2 weeks ago, and we see more and more customers here. One of the reasons why we have opened this lounge is because the other one was close to full. So it's encouraging that we are seeing that.
Encouraging, and things are getting better. The CEO of Iberia, who I met at the weekend in Barajas in Madrid Airport.